For the first question, what is coding? If you Google this question, you get this. And although I myself am familiar to coding, even I can understand this definition. So in layman's terms, this is you talking to another human. You talk in English or Urdu or whatever, and he or she understands it. Now, if you replace the human with a computer and try talking to it in English, it won't understand anything. You have to change your language to something it does understand. This language is called coding. But what do we use it for? We use this to be able to talk to computers and have them do our work for us. What work can they do? Well, of course, we know what computers can do. We can use them in phones, computers, cars, automated houses, drones, aircraft, machines, architecture. The list is literally infinite. But I know what your real question is. Your question is, you, a mechanical engineer, why would you need to code? Well, you're probably saying, I'll just be making machines like these, and I'll have a software engineer do the coding for me. But even so, when you're working on a project, it's not just you. You have a group of people, you have a group of engineers, including civil engineers, electrical engineers, and yes, software engineers. All of you need to work together, which is only possible if each of you understands what everyone else is doing and what everyone else's job is and how they do it. This is the first step to a healthy communication, and only through this were the engineers that came before us able to make machines like this. And only through this will we be able to make machines better than this. So that's why you need to learn to code, but here's how you actually code. Searching coding up on the internet will give you these images. And these are scary. Okay, they send shivers down your spine. This is your reaction after seeing them. But it's not as complex as you've seen. I need you to calm down because it's actually really easy. Coding is taught in a very easy way, and I'll show you the process of how I myself learned to code. And here's the first lecture I took. I'm making burgers. It's so easy. I went through it like hot knife through butter. And making burgers gradually evolved into this. But by the time I got here, I wasn't scared about this. I wasn't scared about this. In fact, I was the one who made this. So it's a very gradual slope, and you'll be comfortable throughout the learning journey. And next lecture, I'm back to making burgers, but now I also know how to make ice cream. So this is how the process is. It's very easy. Now, over most courses, you'll be learning the basics of most of the coding principles applied to some of the most user-friendly coding languages. These are languages which are very easy to use for beginners, and many are actually used by large companies like Google. Now, all these operate using commands called statements, and I'll show you some of these statements along with what they mean. And first of all, this print command, which means to write. Second, it's output command, which means to send. Then there's a while command, which means until. And lastly, there's input command, which means to receive. Now, you'll notice these mean just what they say. It's basic English. So if I just change it into this, it looks much less scary. The thing is, in coding, we have all these brackets and commas and all these different things that make it seem very difficult and very complex, when in actuality, it's basic English. Anyone can be able to understand it. Now, I'd like to talk about one more statement. This is the if statement, and I'll actually show you how to use it in a game, a very popular game called Plants vs. Zombies. Now, here's the if command. We'll put a zombie inside of it. There he is. And we'll give it the command to, if the path to left exists, then we add turn left. So if the path to the left exists, then it'll turn left. And we also add, if it doesn't exist, then you should go forward. And then we'll put this whole command in a loop so that it keeps doing it until it does turn left. Now, if you put it in the game, there's a zombie. You can see there's no path to the left, so it will keep moving forward. Now there is a path to the left, it can go left, keep going straight, and then you can finally eat the plant. And congratulations, if you understood what I did there, you're a programmer already. Because you know a command, and that's all it needs. Now I'll show you something that I actually used by coding, for making my life so much easier. This is my house. At the top, there's a tank, and at the bottom, there's a motor. Now, every day, let's just assume that this is me, this handsome man, that's me. And every day I have to go all the way to the motor, turn on the motor, make sure that the tank is filled, and then turn off the motor, then go back inside. This is how I've been doing for the last 18 years. And now, in the last month, when I've learned coding, I've been able to use a program called Arduino, and I've been able to automate this entire process. Now, when the tank is empty, the system detects it itself and starts the motor. When the tank is filled, it detects it and just stops the motor right there. And there it is, the last 18 years of my life. If I had known this, it would have been so much easier. Now, the last question, is it worth it? I actually asked a similar question to this from you guys in the Mentimeter poll, and let's just go to that. Here we are. And I'm actually disappointed people voted for I don't need to code since I'm a mechanical engineer. Hopefully that was before I actually talked about the aspect. And I'm just lazy. Well, that's your fault. I can't really talk about it. Hard to learn? Well, I already covered that. It's really easy, guys. Just trust me. And it takes too much time to code. And this is, I knew this would be the most voted because this is the most common misconception. The thing is, you're not actually writing the code yourself most of the time, even big firms. For example, this is the coding software. I'll just go to Google. I'll search up Arduino Relay to Ultrasonic Link. Actually, you don't even need a link. There we go. Once it's up, click the first result. Go down here. You see the code is already written. You just need to do this. Control C. And you'll all be familiar by this. Control V. There it is. This is how you code. The thing is, I know what to search. And I know what this code means. That's the difference between you and me. That's what you'll be learning. It's not hard at all. It's not time consuming at all. And it's definitely worth it. As I just showed you myself. So I would really, the question, is it worth coding? I would say yes.